a big trend right now is putting honey into your eyes in order to change the color of your iris.
Putting honey in your eyes will make you go blind. Honey can't even penetrate the cornea deep enough to get to the iris to change the color, but if it did, you would be blinded instantly, or at least get glaucoma. Melanin is the pigment found in nearly all organisms on Earth, except arachnids. This is the pigment that dyes our hair, our skin, and our eyes. Naturally, melanin is dark brown or even black. This is why technically everyone has the same color of eyes, because they're all darkish brown. Now obviously this isn't the case because, well, I have green eyes and a lot of people have other colored eyes besides brown. So why do we see these other colors when the melanin pigment is actually brown? The reason we see these different colors is the same reason that the sky is blue. Rayleigh scattering. Named after the British physicist Lord Rayleigh, Rayleigh scattering is the elastic spreading of light due to particles much smaller than the actual wavelength of light. Things like molecules or atoms. In the case of the iris of our eyes, it's the melanin particles. Brown eyes have a large concentration of melanin, thus they appear the actual color of melanin, because Rayleigh scattering can't really affect them that much. Since blue eyes have much less melanin, the effects of Rayleigh scattering can be seen more prominently. Green eyes, like mine, have much more melanin than blue eyes, but still less than brown eyes. So it's a combination of Rayleigh scattering and the actual pigment of the melanin itself, thus gives you green eyes. In extreme cases of albinism, the amount of melanin is so low in the eye, you can actually see the blood vessels behind the iris, and the eye will actually appear red. But genetically speaking, what determines our eye color? If your dad has green eyes and your mom has blue eyes, what are the odds that you will have blue eyes or green eyes or even brown eyes? Well, scientists aren't exactly sure. It's possible that 16 different genes are responsible for determining the eye color in humans. However, the main genes found to determine eye color are OCA2 and HERC2. Both of these genes are localized in chromosome 15. It is impossible to predict with 100% confidence the actual eye color of a child knowing just the eye color of the parents and even the grandparents. However, we can get pretty close. A great program that I found interesting was the tech.org's eye color calculator, which you can check in the description link below or wherever the box may be. It takes into consideration your parents' eye color as well as your siblings' eye color to determine your future child's eye color. The best rule of thumb for determining eye color is that darker colors tend to dominate. If your spouse has brown eyes and you have blue eyes, odds are your child's actually going to have brown eyes or darker eyes because those genes dominate out the lighter colors. Now, when babies are born, and when they age into adults, their eye colors actually change in the first few years of their life. Most babies are born with blue eyes, and they darken to either darker blue or green or even brown within the first few years of life. In adulthood, after your eye color changes, it really doesn't change at all for the rest of your life. I've heard a lot of people say that their eye color changes when they're upset or angry, and that, you know, emotions will cause their eye color to change. This notion is completely inaccurate. Ivan Schwab, a professor of ophthalmology at University of California, explains that the perceived eye color has nothing to do with emotion, but the way we perceive eye color due to the surrounding colors around us,
such as changing shirts.
Red blood vessels in your eye from anger will actually make your iris appear lighter because of the contrast between the two colors. Dilated pupils from sadness or grief can make your irises appear darker. Since the color of our eye is due to perceived light scattering, I wouldn't be entirely out of line to say that emotions can control the color of our eye. However, the actual pigment of our eyes don't change, and the wavelength of light due to the scattering doesn't change. But the contrast around us, green shirt, blood vessels, dilated pupils, cause us to perceive a different color of iris. If your eyes were to actually change pigments, that would be pretty cool, but it would probably be a sign that you have some sort of ocular disease. If If you wake up one morning and your eyes are an entirely different color, I'd recommend you go see an optometrist immediately. A very, very interesting ocular condition is that of heterochromia. Very occasionally, people and animals will develop an eye color condition where each eye is a different color. It's caused by having relatively different amounts of melanin in each eye. This condition can actually happen in the same eye where different sections of the iris are vastly different colors. Most of the time, heterochromia is a genetic mutation. However, it can be caused by disease or trauma. So if you do wake up one morning with two different colored eyes, or different colored eyes at all, go see an optometrist. Immediately. Thanks for watching this video, and if you enjoyed it, please subscribe for more videos and give me a thumbs up. If you have any more questions, just ask them in the comment section below and I'll be happy to answer. And I'll see you guys next week with another video.